So we have some breaking news for the American people right now. What was going on is Nancy Pelosi ordered, she has, Congress has just passed that a mandate where it's okay to have military around the Capitol building, but not at the Capitol building. So they're telling the military to stand down at the Capitol building, but it could be around it. It's like having a military fire jet without any weapons on it going into battle. How about that?
Well, this is how I see it. I see it where Nancy Pelosi is president of the United States by default because she's calling all the shots, and the entire Congress and the senators, except for including the 10 rhinos who voted against President Trump.
And they're sorry they did now. They're sorry they did. They're sorry that they did. It was Lindsey
Sorry
Graham.
doesn't get it. I'm sorry that they did it. And
Right.
therefore, they're responsible for their choices. We all make
Absolutely.
choices, and the choices came down with a very, very pathetic and anti-American decision.
Yep.
Because President Trump, and I don't care what anybody says, did not create or cause insurrection, but the same people, Black Lives Matter
Antifa.
And Antifa, and incited that, and the FBI knows it, incited that storm into the Capitol.
Right.
And a general stood there talking to the media and said Antifa stormed Pelosi's office and special forces, and they took her laptops. So this mainstream media owned by the New World Order Wall Street billionaires is in control, and they are manipulating through their many years of donations to pre-select these people into office by funding them.
That's right.
And then George Soros and his nonprofit organizations creating civil disruption by recruiting and training up the anarchists who for months were involved in insurrection around the country. And now people are out of work. People are locked down because Dr. Fauci, Obama, and Bill Gates are involved in big pharma for big bucks, and Dr. Fauci
and
Obama
Clinton.
Knew that there was a moratorium on the coronavirus research because it was very dangerous to research the coronavirus. Then Obama granted taxpayer money in a grant to Dr. Fauci to go to Wuhan and continue that research with China, who is a foreign enemy nation. And so I don't just blame China. I blame our United States government for allowing this to happen.
Right,
because
State
if
Department.
That research had not been funded and taken by a United States taxpayer grant granted by Obama to Fauci,
right.
And it's alleged that Soros and Gates own a pharma lab in Wuhan, none of this would have happened, and we don't even know the truth about this flu. We don't know who's actually dying from the flu because the coronavirus flu, because they have morphed all of the causes of death as coronavirus, because we are being ripped off again. Not only did we fund it, the research, we are being ripped off again by
open borders,
by forcing us to taxpayer fund Medicare, who now, admitted by CDC and hospitals and nursing homes, to list every test as a case. And tests are not a case, according to the doctors, but it inflates the numbers to list every patient, even if it was a car accident or a broken arm, as coronavirus, and to list every death and record it as coronavirus. So we have been totally played by Wall Street CEO billionaires who are in the billionaire New World Order Club to redevelop America, depopulate the planet, and 23 people have just been reported to have died in Norway who were vaccinated with the coronavirus. Others are reporting their sides of their face are totally paralyzed, and so is, and some of them it affected the rest of their body. And so we have a lot of issues going on here, and so when they lock the American people out of the White House, the taxpayers pay their wages, the taxpayers pay for that building, all government facilities, and when you have a government who fear the people, who are conservative Christians, some of them are their parents, their grandparents, their cousins, their neighbors, their friends, and they call us domestic terrorists,
when they are
the ones who are in bed with communist China to make big
bucks
and they've made themselves wealthy, we have a serious problem in the USA. And don't forget that it is a federal crime to threaten the President of the United States.
Yes, it is.
Nancy Pelosi threatened to drag the President of the United States out of the White House physically by his hair, and it's all over the news. And Nancy Pelosi and the squad have called him a criminal. They've called him a Nazi, a racist since day one, and they are the ones who've incited this division and these issues of attacking the conservatives because of their rhetoric for 4 years.
Remember, also Nancy Waters said, you know, we need to beat the hell out of them too. Remember, she said that. So did Chuck Schumer. So when we take Georgia, we take the White House. And I want to let you know, there's four Democrats have crossed over to Republicans. We have now got the Senate back. By the way, we got the Senate back. How about that?
Well, that's a very good thing because we're losing our country because of these choices and decisions that if you want to take 13 pieces of silver and go with the Democrats who are in bed with communist China, the Ukraine, and Iran, and they praise a terrorist, and they bash the President of the United States for killing the most dangerous terrorist in the world, who was planning on killing more Americans, more military, and even killed his own citizens. Even the own citizens were cheering that President Trump had killed that most dangerous terrorist. But Pelosi and the Democrats were cheering for him and standing with the Iranian imam who threatened to have President Trump assassinated, and they didn't condemn it. Think about what has happened.
Yeah, I mean, that's crimes against humanity too, as well. Also, it's also of
locking down Americans in their homes and imprisoning us for over a year now with some mysterious monster that's coming.
That's an impeachable offense.
More people are dying from isolation, from lack of funds, and their families are breaking up. They're breaking up the family units. They're causing more abuse. They're causing more depression
and suicide.
I have never seen so many businesses shut down. I drove through my old neighborhood to go visit some relatives, and I was so sad. These places, these small businesses, family-owned, have been around forever.
Yeah,
now
no,
they're struggling
years.
To pay their rent, standing in line for a loaf of bread, while these wealthy people who made their wealth off of making deals with foreign enemy nations are taking bribes and from traffickers like Jeffrey Epstein, who they gave a pass to harm
just
children around the world at Zorro Ranch and Orgy Island and Submarine Island and so forth. These people are not being held accountable, but they have manipulated it because of Wall Street and those who are on the left who want to take down the United States of America, like George Soros stated, devalue the U.S. dollar, bring us to our knees so that they can usher in the one world government and make China the superpower military and economically in this world. And that is treason.
Yes, it is. And yes, also these people who are doing this, instigating these crimes, they should be thrown out of office and be put in Club Gitmo, Cuba, like Chuck Schumer.
So what authority does Nancy Pelosi have to order the military to stand down?
Right. What authority does she just wrote a letter to the National Defense Department, by the way. National Defense Department. She wrote a letter saying that the military cannot be at the Capitol. They could be around it, but they can't be at the Capitol building. They're just opening itself up again for a terrorist attack at the Capitol building.
Let me tell you something.
Is that what they want?
The stated and written strategic goal of the Muslim Brotherhood, CARE, Hamas, jihadist terrorist organization that Obama brought into the USA
and
infiltrated into our government on all levels, their stated and written strategic goal is to wipe out Israel, wipe out America, and dominate Israel, dominate America, and then the whole world. And that is their stated and written strategic goal. And Pelosi allowed them, the squad, to place their hands on a book of foreign ideologies that are bonded with political ideologies that are antithetical to the Bible and to the Constitution of the USA, and ever since she empowered them, they have been screaming to remove President Trump and called him a very nasty word on the world platform, and Congress and the Senate did nothing about it, and neither did Nancy Pelosi, but she joined in ever since with Biden, who said he was going to punch him behind the gym, and if he got the chance, and De Niro, all these Hollywood libs who are going to punch him out. I mean, this is the saddest 4 years in the history of the United States of America, where the Democrat Party and rhinos have embarrassed the United States, shamed the United States, painted the Oval Office worse than President Clinton did with his stain on the blue dress, and he was impeached, and there was nothing. They were not calling him names. They were trying to protect him from being allegedly committing espionage by outsourcing all of America's intellectual property, manufacturing jobs, businesses, and opening the Long Beach Naval Base and the port to communist China with free reign, tariff free, who now owns almost all of America. If you didn't know, just check it out on Wall Street.
Also, I wanted to mention.
But now what we need to do now is focus on the present and 2022 and 2024, and take positive steps to put people into office who are strong, loyal conservatives, and who will, and also begin a future in 2024 to turn all this around.
Can I say something, Rose?
Sure.
Okay, you mentioned a great point here. I just look back at my history a little bit. Okay, going back to 1941. Now, what happened during that was 80 years ago? It seems like we just talked about earlier with this New World Order with the Iran deal. It sounds like they want to become another. A Nazi, Gestapo, The Hitler regime is back again with Iran. It sounds like they want to take it over like they did with the Nazi Germany. It sounds like here we go again with World War III.
It doesn't sound like it. The goal of the New World Order is to bring Americans to their knees, which they're doing, by bringing in this pre-planned plandemic.
Damn.
In the presidential order that I've been posting since 2009, attempting to wake up millions of Americans, and guess what? They still remained asleep until 2012, finally woke up about 2015, and went to the polls in 2016, and the red wave came. And this is a very late stage, because look what happened now, because people involved with the CEOs on Wall Street who fund them, like George Soros, Bill Gates, who are
Bill Clinton,
to buy up all the land,
Bill Clinton Foundation,
especially the farmland in this country,
right,
to get it, because they're
and Jeff Bezos, Amazon,
in Monsanto's GMO seeds, so
right,
we're going to have non-nutritional foods. We're going to have lab-growing meats, lab-growing milk, lab-grown foods. We don't even know what the heck they're putting in them.
Right.
This is a very dangerous path that just happened and is happening today. So Americans need to be very active, peacefully, as President Trump said, patriotically, peacefully, constitutionally, legally, and lawful, and use the laws and use their power to remove these people from office sooner than later by recalls, by voting them out, by planning how to get term limits, how to get proper vetting and make it retroactive for a president of the United States and for a vice president. It's my understanding, and it's alleged, that Kamala Harris' parents were foreign-born. They were not legal citizens.
Right.
They came to the USA. So she is not a natural-born American. She is a naturalized American. Therefore, she is not eligible to be a president of the United States. So one must ask, what is their plan when 78-year-old Joe Biden may have to step down for his health, apparently, which a lot of people believe will happen.
Yeah.
And he even said, well, if Kamala and I disagree, then I'll just die from a disease. Mm. I mean, what kind of a comment is that from a man who's supposed to lead the entire nation?
Right. And because of that, too, what he's doing right now is, well, he's supposed to be, when you take an oath of office, you're supposed to serve and protect foreign and domestic terrorists of all foreign nations. Well, first thing he wants to do is open borders. First thing, he's going to bring people in here.
Well, that's the New World Order plan, George
right.
Soros. He funded the caravans along
right.
with the other billionaires in Hollywood lives. This is what they want. They are going to flood this nation with more unidentified foreigners, healthy males, so they can continue with their national civilian security force, an army that Obama said would be more powerful, more well-funded, more well-trained than the United States military. So when you lock out the U.S. military and you lock out the American people from a presidential inauguration, and you fear 75 million Americans, and you fear the United States military, how are you going to be commander-in-chief? And when you are labeling, like Dick Durbin, the Americans who are conservatives and Christians and patriots and constitutionalists, probably his parents and grandparents and great-grandparents and relatives, and so what you are doing is you are demonizing the entire Republican Party and calling them and labeling them as domestic terrorists. Why are you running for office? Why do you even want to be in office if you have these fears against half of the population and the U.S. military?
Yeah, exactly. Why would you want to Why would you want to bend down and take a knee for these people? I don't know why you want to do that. I don't know. I don't know why you want to do
that. They're demonizing the entire. They didn't demonize just President Trump. They did that to stir up the party.
Yeah.
And they did that so they could undermine his presidency and usher in Biden and Kamala Harris, because the insurrection was not incited by President Trump, as MSM and social media blocked all the truth, blocked all the conservatives, suspended us, banned us, shadow banned us. I don't think my posts have been shadow banned forever. And I've never moved up and if I in followers in 12 years on Twitter, I could tell you that. And they always take away people. They never add people. So that is impossible, strategically impossible and improbable. So we know they play games with conservatives. And so they throw us crumbs, you know. Well, we'll let you post a little bit, and then we'll tell you it's false information. We'll tell you you are creating hate speech. We'll tell you.
I want to tell you about Twitter, by the way.
Let me tell you about Twitter.
I got a Twitter report. I got a Twitter report. I have a Twitter report for you, Rose. You know, the guy who actually was on the agitator of Antifa, and he's actually planning to have a narrow, well, just call it a plan of destruction. I don't want to use anything else because I'm again we're being censored of our own words right now. So but plan of a mass of destruction here. And he said some things that it should not be said on Twitter, but they allow him on Twitter. However, President Trump is banned from Twitter. How is this guy not banned from Twitter? I mean, they talk about a double standard. Well, this is a double standard.
Look, they've had a double standard for, 40-plus years when the Clintons entered the White House in 1993.
Yeah.
The stain was an excuse for what he was actually doing with the open borders and getting in bed with China and the allegations of showing the Chinese leaders and holding a state dinner for the communist Chinese and raising their flag here. A tour of the White House, a tour of national security, hiring spies like Senator Feinstein is alleged to have done for 25 years on her staff, and her husband doing business with communist China. McConnell and his wife is involved with her family in communist China in the shipping industry, making multi-millions of dollars. This is about money. This is all about money.
Yeah,
and their bank accounts, not ours. They want to reduce the population. We are serfs, we're peasants. They threw crumbs at you. They refused to even give you a lousy $2,000. They gave you $600, which equates to $5 a day for the last 4 months. And so they gave more to foreign enemy nations to study transgenderism and same-sex, which are depopulation programs, to depopulate people in their country, because they each have India, Africa, China, all have over 1 billion people and growing. So if the flu, which affects third world nations more than any other nations like China and India and Africa, is killing so many people, then why are they overpopulating?
Right. And also want to point this out to you. Just mention the stimulus money. You know, talking about stimulus money, let's go back to that for a second. You know, what I'm going to call it, the communist dictator in the White House. I don't have a president. I call him the communist dictator in the White House.
Not even a communist dictator in the White House. What he is a puppet with the New World Order.
That doesn't matter. That's fine. $1.2 trillion. He wants to do a stimulus money. Okay. $20 billion of that. Guess where it goes to? Iran.
Well, guess what? It isn't their money. They are treating us as if we are children, as if we are peasants, as if we are their servants, and they are serving themselves from the trough of the taxpayers, and they've been doing it for decades. They never even were supposed to get a taxpayer wage, and then the American people decades ago decided, oh my gosh, we cannot have a poor president when he leaves office, because some presidents were poor. And we can't have a poor vice president. And then it came, well, we can't have poor congressional members. We can't have poor senators. So little by little, the American people, out of the goodness of their heart, said, yes, we'll pay taxes so they can be paid for their work to uphold, defend, protect, and preserve the sovereignty of this great nation, the welfare and safety of the American people, only create laws that were in the best interest of the American people in accordance with the Constitution and the will of the majority of Americans, and they will defend, uphold, protect, and preserve the Constitution, the supreme laws of the land, and the republic that operates by the rule of law. They have done none of it. They have done the opposite. They have become greedy, and they have abused their power, and they have gone into bed with China. They have gotten, and now China's a big influence on our government, and they have, we have spies in universities, we have spies in our government, we have Pakistani spies, we have Iranian spies, because Obama brought them all here with the blessings of Hillary Clinton, pre-planned, secret plan to flood our nation, and they are funded by George Soros and Bill Gates and these New World Order Wall Street people, and flood our nation, create chaos, create civil disruption, create financial distress. People are losing their homes. Americans who pay their wages are losing their homes. Why are they angry? Why are they upset? Why are they frustrated? Because they have us imprisoned in our homes, and there is no constitutional authority to do that, because the rate of death has not changed that much in the world or in the USA. And we are a free people who are guaranteed freedom, freedom of choice, freedom of free will, and the right to work. And under the law, the necessities of life law, we are guaranteed civil rights, constitutional rights, and human rights to work and to sustain the income that provides for the necessities of ourselves and our families and our communities. And therefore, that helps us to help the poor and pay for their welfare checks and food stamps and Obamacare. And then on top of that, we are guaranteed,
we're being punished,
by the U.S. Constitution, human rights and civil rights, to sustain our lifestyle through working and going to school and maintain a sound mind and an education by going to school.
We don't have a school right now. We don't have a school right now during lockdown.
School, work, operating our businesses. They've locked us out of our businesses.
Yeah.
They've locked us into our homes, and they have destroyed families. The rate of divorce has increased. Depression is higher than ever. Abuse is higher than ever. Crime is increasing.
Yep.
Businesses are going out of business every day. And beautiful cities like San Francisco, Poop City, thanks to Governor Newsom, Mayor Garcetti, Dianne Feinstein, Nancy Pelosi, who cared less because she's so obsessed with President Trump, and Maxine Waters, who told the Democrats to confront their fellow Americans who choose to be conservative or vote for President Trump. She told them that's incitement. That is not what President Trump did. President Trump said, let's walk to the Capitol peacefully and patriotically and show them that we support, him for president, and we object to the electoral votes. And then here comes BLM,
during,
and Antifa getting off the buses
during,
to the witnesses.
During the rally. During the rally. It was not a protest. It was a rally. Yeah, it was a it was a rally that we had 2 weeks ago. It was almost 2 weeks ago. We had a rally. It was not a demonstration. It was not a protest. It was a Trump rally. That's all it was. That's all it was.
And there's a pattern. And when you have a pattern, a judge will say you're guilty.
Yeah.
If you went into a store and you stole a piece of gum and you got a pass. Okay,
yeah.
You went in the store and you stole two pieces of gum. You got a slap on the wrist. You went in the store and you stole the whole pack. Okay, now you're really guilty and the judge just may go ahead and punish you. But guess what? There's a pattern, and that pattern is used by judges and lawyers, and they know it, and they should be defending all of this. I've been an advocate for justice and researched the law and have even put my own cases together and won against lawyers. But it wasn't easy. It was a lot of work and effort because so many lawyers are incompetent, let's say.
Yeah.
And so they don't want to do the work. So you have to fight back. You have to fight back against legal abuse. You have to fight back against injustices. You have to fight back against corruption. It's everywhere today because they've gotten away with it for so long.
Yep.
Americans were not involved. And so when you look at it all, the crimes against humanity are the pre-planned pandemic, the pre-planned quarantines, they call lockdowns now, the pre-planned curfews, the pre-planned troops on the ground, which are happening, all of that's happening now. It's in a presidential order. I'm telling you, going all the way back to George H.W. Bush, passed down to every president since. And it's probably written by the New World Order.
Mm.
And because he pledged his allegiance to the New World Order on the House floor, and he was not removed as president because you cannot have two masters. You cannot pledge your allegiance to the United States Constitution and to the New World Order. You can't sit on the fence. You have to choose one side or the other. And they are not friendly. They are enemies of each other. The New World Order is an enemy of capitalism, free enterprise. They're an enemy of sovereignty, God, Bible, Christianity, constitutionalism, Second Amendment, freedom of speech. And they are enemies of free choice and free will. You can equate it to the CCP in communist China and how they abuse their citizens, how they spy on them, track them, execute them, pull them out of their businesses, out of their homes, take them to government facilities.
Yeah, FEMA camps.
Reprogram them. And those are called FEMA camps and FEMA trains, which equate to Hitler and his same agenda for everyone he hated, which weren't only the Jews. He hated the Christians. He hated the gays. He hated the blacks. So anybody that got in his way that he didn't believe was the race that he approved of were sent to gas chambers and experimented upon and abused and raped and starved and so forth. This is a very dangerous path that we are on when Americans, this is a historical
time. We have the Constitution,
time.
Though.
People
and
really
they
need to pay attention.
This is,
we are locked out of our White House, out of the Capitol, out of the presidential inauguration, and these people who are elected in office are fearful.
We don't want to go to the inauguration.
Well, probably 70% of the American people.
We do not want to go to inauguration right now. Think about this. Over 50,000 terrorist threats. I'm telling people, do not go to inauguration. That there's a breach of security there. I mean, they're telling Nancy Pelosi. I just told you, began this program, that Nancy Pelosi told the military not to be at the Capitol, but they could be around the perimeter around the area of the Capitol building. They can't, but they have that they cannot be any presence at all with military personnel at the Capitol building.
Why do they fear the military?
Why they feel military? Because.
And she, what authority does she have over the military?
I want to tell. Two questions here. I want to answer both of them right now. One is they don't like the military. They never have. They're communists. Okay, that's your first question. Second question the second answer I'm going to give you right now. The reason why they hate the military so much and they don't like the military is because of the, again, they don't like public safety. They want to make money off of a terrorist attack. I do believe that that's what their motive is. It's hard to say that, but it seems like in every time this is like what we had in 9/11, almost 20 years this September. And I believe.
Well, guess what? David Horowitz says Democrats will persecute Christians and want a fascist.
There you go. You just answered your own question. There you go. See, you just answered your own question. You just gave me. There you go. See.
That's, well, I know the answers. I'm trying to get people to think.
Right, and I'm giving you what's happening, what the scenarios are.
Don't give it to me. Tell your audience what they're doing.
Right.
I already know. I've been doing this 30 years and telling your audience and my audience and anybody who will listen what they're going to do, and now they're doing it.
Right, exactly. That's precisely right. That's exactly what is going on. And they need people need to be informed, and they're not. And the problem is the fake news media won't. They have the information. They know this. They just won't release it.
Well, like they have a lot of fear and a lot of guilt on their plates because nobody locks the American people who own the White House, the state capitol, out of it
right.
Unless they are on a terrorist list. So are they going to put 75 million people on a terrorist list?
But we already are. We are already categorized as terrorists already. They did this. The Democratic Party.
But not the real terrorists that Obama brought into the USA. With
no.
Hillary,
oh, no. Of course not.
And are stating that they're not going to uphold the Constitution.
They're humanitarian people. They're humanitarian people. That's what they called them. That's what Nancy Pelosi said. They're humanitarian people. So we can actually allow them in and have them give them free Medicare, provide food, provide shelter for them, because we care. We care enough to have them here in America. That's why they want to have open borders.
Attorney Dershowitz says that President Trump did not commit insurrection. And that they don't, basically what I think he's saying is that Pelosi and the entire Democrats and Republicans who voted to impeach him on insurrection committed an unconstitutional act. And I think that's what they're afraid of. Because when you impeach a president, if they don't convict him, according to what I read, and so don't quote me, this is what I read, and it's alleged, let's say then, just to protect that, is that then he is, and he's acquitted, he then can run for two more terms if he's acquitted, because then the impeachment is nullified. And that, in my opinion, after reading that, appears to me that was the reason she wanted to rush the second impeachment, because he could run for two more terms. So, and at least one more term, we know. And so it appears that she rushed the second one because she wanted to make sure that he could never ever run for office of the president again in 2024.
Right.
And so she accused him of insurrection, but never accused BLM and Antifa of George Soros, who funded this with the Open Society, Super PACs, Act Blue, Hollywood Libs, and so forth.
Jeff Bezos from Amazon.
She never, ever says insurrection. So how hypocritical is this when President Trump, according to Alan Dershowitz, did not commit insurrection, and yet the entire Congress and 10 rhinos and even Speaker McConnell went for it and jumped into China with Nancy Pelosi.
Right. Also, I want to talk about, touch on this a little bit, too. We mentioned about big tech, big media. Did you know with Parler, Amazon, Jeff Bezos, you got Tumblr, you have LinkedIn, you have also, now you have Flickr, another one, canceling Parler. But guess what? The Wall Street Journal on their app, they have Parler back, by the way. They're coming back, by the way. Parler's coming back because of the lawsuit that they had to do, actually get making sure, because it's unconstitutional. And this, and it was the Attorney General of the state that Parler's at, and I guess in Florida, the Attorney General said that this is unconstitutional, and so he put into law, enforcing the law, making sure that is done correctly. So here's what you do, red states. This is a message for all red states, not the blue states. You guys have no law at all whatsoever. There's no law in the blue states. However, the red states, you go to your attorney general, you enforce the Constitution, and right now, did you know there's 20 attorney generals in all the red states that have filed an impeachment against Joe Biden. He's not even in office yet, for violation of his oath of duty, serving, protecting the Constitution. I mean, the first thing he's going to do is he's going to tear down a border wall. Well, guess what? That's unconstitutional. You have to serve and protect, and that is in the Constitution. See, these people, well, they're abusing power. Like you said, they're abuse of power.
In the past, the public servant had to have clean hands.
Right.
They had to be transparent and honest,
right.
And they had to have proper background checks. And they don't do that anymore since Obama came into office.
That's right.
And they didn't do it for, as far as I'm concerned, with Clinton either, because he had fled the draft.
Right.
And so, and he lied
Johnson.
To a
also don't forget Johnson
an
too.
Officer, a captain, a
don't
general,
forget Johnson. You
no
forgot Johnson.
He was coming back, and he did not. He fled from Oxford over
President
to
Johnson.
And so there was a
same
lot
thing.
Of issues going on
this
there,
been going
but
on for
6 years.
Since
Obama was elected, was put into slip.
Nah, it's been going on since the Johnson era. This is going on since the Johnson era. It's been going on for 6 years. That's ridiculous. That's just, it's gone too far, too much, too fast. And this is exactly what the Roman Empire was all about, too, by the way. It was a fall of the Roman Empire. That's exactly what's going to happen to the Democratic Party. They're going to fall just like the Roman Empire did. They built their empire so much power, so much corruption. It's going to fall. That's what the Roman Empire did. You know, I want to compare what the Democrats are doing to the Roman Empire. That's what you're seeing right now, the Democratic Party. They're just,
well, what happened is that...
it's going to happen, folks.
What happened is that they had this a lot of money to do what they've done, and they have self-protected themselves by putting into place people that they've known for 40 years, and they just placed
Caesar did it.
Chairs.
Pilot did it.
To like USAG and the AG and the director of the FBI and all these who are players with the Clintons and all these New World Order people, George Soros and all these.
Right.
And so they're
King
not
Monarchs.
Just friends and BFFs, and then they use their families to do deals with foreign enemy nations to create their family dynasties secretly in the dark. And then they also take donations like from the Clinton Foundation for
some
nonprofit or other cause. It's like a third party to take the focus off of the person who it is actually benefiting, so that they can't say, well, you took 50 $30,000 in donations, and that's a conflict of interest. So they use their wives and their kids and to do all of this secret funding. And so we have Pelosi, who is alleged to have committed insider trading three different times that made her multi-millions of dollars. She wasn't held accountable, but Martha Stewart went to jail. Right. And these are the same people who are telling us what, how ethical they are and what a crook President Trump is.
Right. Also, I want you know, too, talk about criminals. You know, as you know, you have enough vote for, like, by the election coming up, too, as well. But we have enough votes to impeach, recall Governor Newsom now. You guys have enough votes in California to do this. Hooray.
Well, that's how we're going to do it. We're going to recall people. We're going to vote out people. We're going to check
there
out
you go.
People very, very carefully. And we're going to look up their records, and we're going to vote out the people who are rhinos. This is how
they
we
go
do
to the voting office.
Fully unconstitutional.
Don't mail, no more mail-in ballots. Go to the voting office. Go in person. Show your ID card. We're going to have to do that. We're going to show your ID card. We're going to show your, making sure that you are who you say you are with your driver's license ID, a voter ID. We need to have that at the voting election office. And don't go no more mail-in ballots. We're going to do it in the voting office.
Well, Speaker Pelosi said adoption of a war powers resolution.
She can go to jail for that, by the way. She can go to jail for this.
Military actions against Iran.
She can go to jail for that. You know, these people can go to jail for this.
Iran? They're protecting Iran, who threatened to wipe America off.
You see, again, they're jeopardizing public safety. They don't realize what they're doing. They don't know. And that's exactly why the attorney generals are against this kind of Gestapo technique against the Constitution, because that's what they're breaking right now. As a whole idea, they're breaking their own laws, by the way. They're manufacturing their own laws, and they're breaking their own laws, and that goes against the Constitution. And that is a peaceable offense, by the way. And that's why we need to throw these people out of office before they get too corrupt and too big, and gotta get rid of them. And by doing so, we go into the ballot box, we go in there, we go recall these people, we do it legally. Not forcibly, we do it legally, and we bring.
And that's how the Trump supporters have always done it. It's been the BLM and Antifa right. That was created and funded and trained up and recruited by the
that's
left.
That's correct.
And supported,
terrorists.
And they allowed the insurrection to continue all through 2020 and during their plandemic as well. We're telling us we had to be locked down in our house while they were partying in the streets till all hours of the night, and they were burning down.
We not party. Is a it was a terrorist.
How many police they killed? They torched police. I saw it on video.
I know.
They actually set them on fire. They set a
police office building in Portland.
They women and children out of cars and yeah. Pummeled them. And these people are saying President Trump is violent.
Yeah, I know. I see, again, a double standard again. And that's exactly, and guess who's promoting this? You can think Facebook and Twitter promoting these kind of people. They're promoting these kind of people, and they don't block them. However, they block President Trump. You see, this is why we do what we're doing, because we're exposing the truth here. We are reporting the truth. No speculation, not conspiracy theory, real facts, real truth. This is what we do here. This is what we do here on this network. It's tough. That's hard. But you know, somebody has to do it.
I'd like to know why Nancy Pelosi is calling up a and speaking to a general on Kirby Trump's military power as House weighs impeachment, because. What influence does she have, and what constitutional authority is what I would like to know, does she have to ask the general to curb his authority, his executive authority as a commander-in-chief of the military, so that they can stand down, basically, and not charge anyone with being traitors with China, Ukraine, Iran, Iraq, Qatar, and all these other foreign enemy nations.
How can you get away with that? Exactly. She's not president.
They like their old friends in office, and they don't want Trump in office, especially China, because they can easily continue to influence their old friends in high places.
Yeah. I know. It makes no sense at all. It makes no sense. I know. I don't know what authority does she think she has.
And then she's talking unstable when she can't even complete a sentence many times.
I know.
And she makes no sense in some of her statements. And on top of that, and they're on video. I'm not making this up. Everybody has seen them. And then on top of it, Joe Biden, I can't bring myself to call him president. Sorry. But
I'm not either. I'm calling the dictator in the White House. That's what I said, dictator in the White House.
I mean, what my gut feeling and my heart and soul tell me he's not, and it's all a sham, then I just can't. And I'm a very strong, I have a very strong gut feeling about people. And I can just look at them, even if it's on
he's online. Well.
And I can see if they're good people or if they've got bad intentions for America and Americans, which happened to me when the first time I saw them introduce Barack Obama on the House floor. I couldn't look at him. I couldn't hear him. I knew he came from the dark side. I'm not talking about race. I'm not talking about skin color. I'm talking about what was
political agenda. His political agenda. Exactly. Nothing personal about the person. It's a political agenda. That's what this is.
It was about his political agenda, and I could read through him. Right. I stated he had tunnel vision, and that he had he was on a mission, and that he was not flexible, and he would be the most dangerous man to hit our nation. In my opinion, and I believe that statement was true and factual, posted on Town Hall. I also wrote an article in 2008 stating China on the move, China in, America out, and that was online for a long time. And that hit the nail on the button, too, because I was telling people to keep their eye on communist China, because they were the quiet sleeping giant that was going to unleash their dragon on America.
Right.
And here we are.
Yeah, I know. Here we are. So anyway, we're going to wrap it up here. Anything else? I'm just going to wrap it up really quickly here. I don't want to spend much more time here because I know we.
Yes, I would like to leave one last message.
Right.
America is the greatest nation in the entire world. Everybody on Wall Street and everybody who has been elected to office or appointed to office was given the greatest honor ever to represent the greatest nation ever and to uphold, defend, and protect and preserve the Constitution of the United States of America. And you were trusted to protect the American people, the legal American people, the natural-born Americans innate to this soil, who are loyal to the United States of America, who fought for this country, who died for this country, who's injured for this country, and the civilians who also stand up, speak out, and fight back against great odds today, and that if you join the Democrats in this quest to attack 75 million loyal constitutionalists, patriots who love this nation, love you, pray for you, that you leave the dark side and that you come to the light and that you ask God to forgive you, repent, and Americans will forgive you too, if, as President Trump told you, do the right thing for your children, for your grandchildren, so they can live in a free nation and know what it is to build a lemonade stand, know what it is to earn money, know what it is to save money, know what it is to honestly buy something with good, honest money. Do not support the Democrats who bashed a duly elected president of the United States by legal votes in 2016 and 2020. He did not commit insurrection. He did not want anything bad to happen to blacks, whites, or anyone else. He sent the National Guard to preserve this nation, to calm down the nation, to stop Soros and Obama and Hillary and Pelosi, Biden, Harris, Schumer from destroying cities, your businesses, your livelihood, your cities, your churches where you worship. He was for opening the country, setting us free. We are being enslaved like the Egyptians enslaved Israel. We are regressing like Hitler enslaved the Jews and the Christians and the Poles and the gays and the blacks. How Margaret Sanger, who Biden and Hillary embraced and spoke for up for them to and called the black Americans predators, super predators. They lived in jungles. They didn't want them around their families. They wanted them imprisoned and wrote the law to imprison the black Americans and order them to stay in prison and serve 85% of their sentence, no matter even if they were innocent. This is what you have voted for if you are a rhino or you are on the left. You are leaving your children without the ability to know America, to know the history of America, to know the history of their ancestors, to know the history of the men and women who fought for this country so that we could be free, so that we could live in peace, so that we could be sovereign. Why do you think billions of people want to live in America? They will walk thousands of miles. They will climb mountains like the pilgrims did, sail oceans in dangerous storms to get to America.
Yeah, resting
life. We are not China. They have their own country. We have our own country. Tell China to go back home and the communists and to continue on with their own agendas in their own country and to leave our sovereign nation alone. And that goes for all other sovereign nations. Pray that they rid themselves of communism and that one day their citizens will all know freedom. But we do not want to know communism in the USA. And we are locked out of the White House. We are now called domestic terrorists by a future
dictator.
So-called president of the United States.
Nope, not, don't use that word.
Democrat Party. And this is what you have to realize. God is in control, and we can take back our country peacefully, legally, lawfully, recalls, voting out, changing laws, and term limits. Term limits, number one.
Also,
God bless you, and thank you for listening to Mark E. Burrell Show. This is The Rose signing off.
All right. Well, anyway, I want to put this in for you, too, as well. This is for people, too. I just want to do this for you. This is the greatest nation on God's green earth. Remember, in God we trust. This is what we're founded on. This is what this country is based on. This country is based on freedom, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. So the people who want to join the Republican Party We welcome you with open arms, and we will honor you and we respect you. We will not attack anybody here. So unless we get attacked upon first, we will not attack anybody. So thank you so much.
You're welcome. God bless you.
God bless. Bye-bye.